فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
مخالفة الثقة, a reliable person is opposing another reliable person, but this person's integrity is higher than this person. They both have integrity. Are you there, brothers? The second one is the opposition of a thiqah liman huwa akthar minhu adada. He's opposing a people who are more than him in number. Does that make sense? Brothers, are you with me? Pay attention now. This person is what? Thiqah. He's reliable. He's opposing another person who is thiqah. This thiqah who is lower than this person, this riwayah is called mahfuz, and this one's narration is going to be called shadh. That's what he's trying to tell you. فَالرَّاجِحُ الْمَحْفُوظ. The one that's going to be accepted, which is from the great thiqah, is called mahfuz. This hadith is mahfuz now. We're taking this to your narration. Mahfuz, jazakallah. Your narration, shadh. But there's an opposition between the two. Are you with me, brothers? Huh? What about now, if he opposes people who are more than him in number? Same thing again. Theirs are going to be called mahfuz, and his one's going to be called what? Shad. Does that make sense? What about this now? That's all one type, right? The second type is a person who's weak. Goes and he opposes people who are somebody who's better than him, greater than him. Or he opposes a people who are larger than him in number. Are you there? What's his narration called? Munkar. And their one is called what? Their one's called Ma'ruf. Theirs is called Ma'ruf. Ma'ruf is the opposite of a munkar narration. Whereas Mahfuz is the opposite of a shad narration. The reason why they want to tell you is that this hadith opposes a weak, or it opposes a authentic hadith. Does that make sense to everybody here? That's very important that you understand. Walidhalika, this is again, Ibn Hajar here, every place you could have a lesson and explain more, but what you need to realize is that there are somebody who, if he opposes many, or if he opposes this or opposes that, he's just always going to be taken. One person, he's always going to be taken. There are some scholars who are like that. Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, I will take him over 100 people. I don't care what anybody has to say. Are you with me? Because of his memory and his precision and his reliability, he's been tested to the core. So Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan's narration, Ahmad rahimahullah says, I will take it بغض النظر عن من خالفه. I don't care who proposes him. Does that make sense? So not every opposition do you jump to. Plus another thing you have to realize is that verify, is there an opposition first of all? Is there an khilaf aslan? If there's no khilaf, then why are you going to say to shad and mahfuz? Sah? Moving the finger. Yeah. Moving the finger in the tashahud, there's no khilaf, there's no mukhalaf aslan. To say that there's shad and there's mahfuz. Because the Arabs, they call pointing at something with your finger still and pointing somebody by saying to them, come here, and moving your finger, they both call it tahriq. I mean, they both of them are known as tahriq, according to the Arabs. So you can't result to say it's opposition. There's no opposition here. Haraftum? You can only result to shad and mahfuz when there is an opposition. According to the Arabic language, whether you move your finger or whether you don't move your finger, they call it ishara. Ishara is, it falls under moving the finger and not moving the finger. So the riwayah of Zaidah ibn Qudama al-Thaqafi does not oppose the riwayat of the other ruwat. It doesn't have any harm, aslan. Na'am.
قال رحمه الله تعالى والفرد النسبي إن وافقه غيره فهو المتابع وإن وجد متن يشبهه فهو الشاهد وتتبع الطرق لذلك هو الاعتبار.
Now the author goes into another issue. Restricting it to gharab al-nisbi is incorrect on the side of the author. It can also happen in the fardu al-mutlaq as well. It's not specific to fardu al-nisbi. Basically what it means is that if this hadith is gharib, is singular, and there comes another narration and it supports it, and this narration are both coming from what? They're both coming from one sheikh, from one teacher. So two people are narrating from one teacher. Both of them are giving each other what is known as mutaba'ah. It all goes back to one companion. All one narration. This narration is supporting the other narration. Are you with me, brothers? Whereas, if this narration has a meaning in it, that some may weaken it, but it has another narration that supports the meaning, the overall meaning, then it's a shahid, even if they're not the same narration, even if it's not from the same companion. Are you with me? Even an ayah could be a shahid for a hadith. Shahid, it just means it testifies to this concept. Are you with me, brothers? Like for example, some of the scholars, they weaken the narration where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, من كان على مثل ما أنا عليه اليوم وأصحابي. All ستفترق أمتي على 73 فرقة. All of my ummah are going to be divided into 73 sects. All of them are in the hellfire except who? Except what? Except the one who is upon that which I and my companions are upon. Some weaken that narration. They said it's incorrect. Some of the muhakkiqeen of the ilm al-hadith have weakened it. Are you with me, brothers? Brothers, are you there? And they said it's weak. We have a shahid for it. Whether you guys weaken that narration or not. We have a what? Shahid for it. What's the shahid? The other riwayah that has another different companion who the Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Jama'ah. We'll say when the hadith came down and the Prophet said, Jama'ah. Who were the Jama'ah at that time? The Prophet and his companions. There was no other Jama'ah. That's a shahid. Weaken if you want, but now it has been authenticated. By what? By this meaning. Does that make sense? This is called a shahid. Whereas a mutaba'ah is different. Mutaba'ah means they're both from the same hadith, from the same shaykh, from the same sanad, from the same companion. This is called a mutaba'ah. And the i'tibar means this effort that we just did right now, which is we were following the narrations and saying this narration supports this narration. The tatabu' of the narrations and the work, the hard work that you're putting in to find an extra narration to support this and that. This work is called i'tibar. Does that make sense, brothers? This work of yours, وَتَتَبُّعُ طُرُقِ لِذَلِكَ هُوَ الْاِعْتِبَارُ. The following, it is. And the mutaba'ah has two types, which is one that's known as mutaba'ah tamma, and a mutaba'ah which is mutaba'ah which is qasara, short. نعم.
قال رحمه الله تعالى ثم المقبول إن سلم من المعارضة فهو المحكم وإن عرض بمثله فإن أمكن الجمع فهو مختلف الحديث أو ثبت المتأخر فهو الناسخ والآخر المنسوخ وإلا فالترجيح ثم التوقف.
Go back to the maqbool and the mardood. What did we say the maqbool was categorized into? How many did we say we categorized the maqbool into? What were they? The first one was, what was the in terms of its levels. The levels is what was divided into sahih and hasan, right? And what was the other one, second one? Yeah? I didn't say it, good. Write it now. This is where he goes into. It's in terms of implementing it and not implementing it. I'm going to just write in terms of implementation. بِاعْتِبَارِ الْعَمَلِ بِهِ أَوْ عَدَمُ الْعَمَلِ بِهِ. That's what he's going into now. Are you with me, brothers? بِاعْتِبَارِ الْعَمَلِ بِهِ أَوْ عَدَمُ الْعَمَلِ بِهِ. Are you with me, brothers? Are you there, brothers? And that is divided into two. That one is categorized into how much? Into two. مَعْمُولٌ بِهِ, that which you have to implement. And the second one is غَيْرُ مَعْمُولٍ بِهِ, that which you don't have to implement. or that which you don't implement. The ones that you have to implement is called al-muhkam and the nasikh. You have to implement those. The muhkam and the nasikh you implement, right? And the second one, which is the ones you don't implement, are two: mukhtalaful hadith, and the mansukh. Sah? The mansukh. Are you with me, brothers? One more time. The hadith, which is maqbool, is categorized into two. The first one was what? In terms of its levels. That which we divide into sahih and hasan. صحيح لذاتي حسن لذاتي صحيح لغيره حسن لغيره. Then we are now going on to in terms of implementation. We divided that into two: those which you have to implement and those which you don't implement. معمول به, and the other one which is غير معمول به, right? The معمول به, we said it is what? المحكم and الناسخ. And المحكم and nasikh, and that which you don't implement is known as what? Mukhtalaf al-hadith al-mansukh. Sah? Now let's define what it means. So the author is now going to tell us what's muhkam, which we have to implement, and what's the opposite of muhkam? The opposite of muhkam is mukhtalaf al-hadith. The opposite of nasikh is mansukh. Does that make sense? Muhkam means the hadith that we know its meaning and there's no problem. There's no opposition of this meaning. It's not contradicting itself. Are you with me? Are you with me, brothers? Naam. The hadith which is, it has an opposition. Are you with me? It has an opposition. There's another narration standing in front of you that's opposing it, the meaning. This is called mukhtalaful hadith. Are you there? Mukhtalaf al-hadith, by the way, means there is a way to reconcile between it. We still can bring them together, but they're opposing each other. There's a mu'arada, but there's mumkinul jam'a. We're able to bring them together. Are you there? Brothers, are you with me? Whereas the nasikh and the mansukh is an opposition, which we can't bring them together. So we reconcile. What we're doing is we're taking one over the other. Are you there? It's a mu'arada between the two hadiths. We can't call it mukhtalaful hadith, because mukhtalaful hadith is called when we can. This is the tricky part. Many people confuse. Mukhtalaful hadith doesn't mean nasikh and mansukh. There's a difference. There's a mu'arada. These hadiths are opposing each other. If we can bring them together and make them hold hands and leave, then this is called mukhtalaful hadith. Al Imam al-Tahawi wrote a book on this, and he deals with this. A hadith which seem to be contradicting, he brings them easily together. Are you with me? Whereas if they're contradicting each other and we're unable to reconcile between the two, we then take the point which is nasikh and mansukh, the abrogated and the abrogator. Are you with me, brothers? If that's even an English word, abrogator. Sounds like Terminator. Sah? The one that's abrogating and the one that's abrogated. We now have to look at time then. Which one came first? Are you with me, brothers? If we can't do that, the author then says, ثُمَّ التَّوَقُّفُ. Is مُخْتَلَفُ الْحَدِيثِ couldn't happen, we couldn't bring them together. We tried nasikh and mansukh, it wasn't working. We even tried tarjih. We tried to resort to tarjih, which is what? عام, خاص, مطلق, مقيد, مجمل, مبين. We tried all of that, it didn't work. Then what do we take? Be quiet, leave it to Allah. Somebody might more knowledgeable than you might come years to come, and he might be able to resolve this problem. Does that make sense? Does that make sense, brothers? We've now, walillah alhamdu wal minna, we've finished maqbool. You've studied maqbool. That's it. All of maqbool is over. We're now going to go to the second type of hadith in terms of its weak and its strength. What was it? Mardood. We're now going to go into mardood. Today you finished al-maqbool, a hadith which is accepted. Are you with me, brothers? Now we're going to go to reject the hadith. Are you? So far, is it easy the way he explained? No. Huh? 50-50 a year. Somewhere like 10.
In the board.
Yeah, board would be better. هيا فضل.
قال رحمه الله تعالى ثم المردود إما أن يكون لسقط أو طعن فالسقط إما أن يكون من مبادئ السند من مصنف أو من آخره بعد التابعي أو غير ذلك فالأول المعلق والثاني المرسل والثالث إن كان باثنين فصاعدا مع التوالي فهو المعضل وإلا فالمنقطع ثم قد يكون واضحا أو خفيا فالأول يدرك بعدم التلاقي ومن ثم احتيج إلى التأريخ والثاني المدلس ويرد بصيغة تحتمل اللقي كعن وقال وكذا المرسل الخفي من معاصر لم يلق.
The author رحمه الله now goes to مردود, the rejected hadith. Now write this down. مردود is two types. The rejected hadith is two types. The first one is بسبب سقط من السند. The first reason is, as the author mentioned, is some disconnection of the narration. The hadith is disconnected. Are you with me, brothers? And that's two types. And that's what? Two types. There's ظاهر, apparent one. The disconnection is apparent. I can see it. And it's khafi, hidden one. It's what? It's khafi, it's hidden. You can't see it. Are you with me, brothers? The apparent one, which is known as the ظاهر, is four types. The author mentions all four of them for you. Yeah. There are how many? Four types. The first one, the author mentions it. If it's at the beginning of the chain of narration. When we say the beginning, we mean Bukhari's teacher. Not from the Prophet's way. From the author's way. Does that make sense? So, from the author, Bukhari doesn't mention his teacher. That's the first one. And Bukhari is just an example. It could be any other narrative scholar. Brothers, are you with me? What's it called? Mu'allaq. That's the first one. Mu'allaq means أَيَّكُونَ مِن مَبْدَئِ السَّنَدِ. It's from the beginning of the chain. Bukhari doesn't mention his teacher. The second one is أَوْ مِنْ آخِرِهِ بَعْدَ التَّابِعِي. Are you with me? The second one is right at the top. أَيْ تَابِعِي attributes a statement to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Now some people do this mistake and it's a very, very common mistake. I even saw recently on the Sharh of Bayquniyah. This is a mistake that many people do. Which is that they take the statement of Al-Imam Al-Bayquni correct, they take it as it is. When he says, وَمُرْسَلٌ مِّنْهُ الصَّحَابِيٌّ سَقَطْ وَقُلْ غَرِيبُ مَا رَوَى رَوٍ فَقَطْ. They say, وَالْمُرْسَلٌ مِّنْهُ الصَّحَابِيٌّ سَقَطْ. That mursal is when a companion drops. No, it's not. Because if I knew a companion dropped, I would have taken the narration. Because all the companions are reliable to me. I don't need to know which companion it is. Does that make sense? And the reason I'm not taking it is because there's a possibility he could have narrated from my tabi'i. Are you with me, brothers? That's why some scholars, they said Sa'id ibn al-Musayyab's irsal, it's taken. The hadith that Sa'id al-Musayyab is a tabi'i, he never met the messenger. If he says that the Prophet said, scholars, they said, yeah, we'll take it from him. Because 98% of his teachers were who? Companions. So even if you drop somebody, what was the chances he was going, who he dropped? A companion. Whereas Zuhri, who's min sighari tabi'in, he's from the small tabi'in, who 98% of them were his tabi'in, that he took from, other tabi'in. They were like, if he dropped somebody else, the chances is what? And Imam al-Shafi'i in Kitab al-Risala, he gave five conditions that he would accept the narrations of Sa'id al-Musayyab as irsal, as mursal. Are you with me, brothers? He'll accept it. And he gave it five conditions. Scholars generally bring it in their books. So pay attention to this mistake. It's not right. The mursal is when a tabi'i says, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, and we know So it's the best definition to say is إرسال is ما رفعه التابعي إلى النبي. That's the best. It's whatever a tabi'i attributes to the Prophet. Because إبهام الصحابي لا يضر. A sahabi's ambiguity of not knowing which companion it is doesn't harm me, because these, the companions are all reliable. I don't need to know which companion he dropped. If I know, if I'm 100% sure he dropped a companion, then I would have taken it from him. I'm just not sure he did. Could be a tabi'i he dropped. And a tabi'i, I need to know who he is, so I can see his integrity and his... Are you with me, brothers? So that's mursal. Mu'dal means when there's a disconnection of two consecutive individuals. They're one after the other. Two. They can't be one at the back and one at the front. That's not called mu'dal. Mu'dal have to be two people next to each other. They have to be right next to each other. That's why وَمُعْضَلُ السَّاقِطُ مِنْهُ اثْنَانِ بَيْقُونِ You got that wrong again. Because he forgot a condition which is مُتَوَالِيَانِ They have to be next to each other. Tawali is important. Or else it will be what? Every مُعَلَّق and a مُرْسَل if it happens at the same time, then we'll say it's a مُعْضَل. It's not a مُعْضَل. مُعْضَل is when two people drop. Are you with me, brothers? A hadith, can it be مُعْضَل and it can it be مُعَلَّق at the same time? Of course it can. If Bukhari drops his teacher and his teacher's teacher. So he's dropped his teacher, which is mu'allaq already. He dropped two consecutive people, is what? Mu'dal. And the fourth, which is the last one, is called munqata'. Munqata' means whenever a hadith is disconnected. Are you with me? So is a mursal munqata'? Na'am. Is a mu'dal munqata'? Na'am. Is a mu'dal munqata'? Na'am. And is it, if it happens, one narrator in the middle by itself, this now becomes muqatta' by itself. Does that make sense? Are you there? Muqatta' is a bit more, it's all of them and extra. Are you with me, brothers? So all of those four that I mentioned are apparent. Generally, everybody can tell them. It's not hard to see that. Does that make sense? Especially at the ending of Nukhbatul Fikr, he's going to show us that if you know the life and the birth of every narrator, when he died, everything, this is simple. The second type, which is khafi, hidden, and the author mentions them too, which is the second one. The second form of disconnection in the narration is khafiyun, is hidden. And it is what? It is what is known as mudallas. Mudallas means what? Mudallas is saqt, which is khafi. This connection here is hidden. It's hidden. A mudallas means a person who took from somebody. Like, for example, I'll take this as a prime example. Yesterday, let's say I gave a sitting here and I narrated hadiths. Faisal wasn't here. But is he here today? Did he meet me? Has he been with me? Naam. He now says, Abdul Rahman said yesterday. He won't say I heard it from him, but he said yesterday. What would you think? That he heard it from me. He will use the word qala, an. But he's met me. This is called tadlis. You can't really tell this is a disconnection. Hard. It's hidden, right? Because he didn't meet me. There's no disconnection you can see. But there is, because he wasn't here yesterday. Are you with me? He's dropped somebody who he heard it from. Mursal, on the other hand, is the same. But the only difference between Mursal is what? He never met me in my life, but we lived at the same time. There's a mu'asara, لكن لم يلقى. That's Mursal, Mursal Khafi. Mursal Khafi is different from the Mursal that we took before. Mursal Khafi means there's a mu'asara. They both resided at the same time, but they never met each other. صح? Like, for example, some of you guys have not met Sheikh Salah Usaymi, right? Are you with me? Could you have met him? Yes. Yeah. So you heard something from Sheikh Salah Usaymi through from Sheikh Yasin. Then what do? You drop Yasin. And you say, Usaymi, Sheikh Usaymi said. Could you have met Sheikh Usaymi? Naam. Did you live at the same time as him? You did. But you just done mu'asara, you just reside at the same time as him, but you don't really meet him. This is called mursalu khafi. It's also hard to tell. Does that make sense, brothers? Are you with me, brothers? That's what the author is mentioning here. Fadl, carry on. Are you all brothers understanding the class? Which one? The sakht is two types. Sakht, which is zahir, apparent, and it's four. Mu'allaq, mu'dal, munqati, and mursal. Then the second comes, which is khafi, it's hidden. The khafi is, the hidden, is basically when a person who met a person, like Faisal met me, but wasn't there for that day yesterday when I was narrating the hadith. He wasn't there. He met me, we've spent time together, we know each other, but he never met me yesterday. So he can't claim he heard this hadith from me. So what he would do is, he doesn't like the idea of having to narrate this hadith from Yunus. He doesn't like it, because it's going to be long. He wants to shorten his narration. So he would drop Yunus out, just an example, okay? And Yunus is very weak. Yunus is like, before I even said it, he's like, no, he dropped Yunus out because the memory and the understanding of Yunus is weak. That's why he's doing it. So he doesn't, he wants to make his, so what he does is that he won't lie. If he lies, then he's a kadhab, so he becomes a liar. So we're not taking it. But he just says, Abdurrahman said. And I did say it. But not to you. To Yunus. But he'll trick you guys. He done tadlis. Tadlis is to beautify the narration. He'll say, qala, an. But he met me. Mursal, on the other hand, is a person who's in America, who's never met me. But who lived at the same time as me. He hears this narration from Yunus. He's never met me. We did live at the same time. He heard it from Yunus instead of me. And he says, Abdurrahman said. Now, it's hard to tell because he could have, any time of the day or in the year, he could have traveled and come to me. It's hard to tell because it's the same time we resided. Now.
So, you're saying that the Tabi lived at the same time as the Prophet ﷺ.
No, it's nothing to do with the tabi'i, this one. No, this is a different mursal. Mursal here, khafi, is nothing to do with the mursal which is zahir.
Okay.
It's a type of tadlis.
Is there something to do with the term haddathana?
We're going to come to that, beautiful. This is turuq and the siyaq of tahammul, we're going to come to it, inshallah ta'ala.
One
more. Huh? Hey?
And the normal mursal is not when the tabi'i
which one, Mursal?
Yeah,
that's the regular one, which is the Zahir. The Zahir Mursal is got to do with the Tabi'i saying, Qala Rasulullah. That's when it's Zahir, when you hear the word Mursal only. But if you hear Mursal Khafi, Mursal Khafi is not the Mursal that you knew. Mursal Khafi is Tadlis, a form of Tadlis. Are you with me? The only difference between the Mudal Tadlis and the Mursal Khafi is just one met and the other one didn't meet. Are you with me, brothers? Nothing to do with Sahabi or Tabi'i. Crystal clear? So the Mursa, the Tadlis, there's Luqi. Ibn Hajar clearly mentions it here. He says it, look. He says, Al-Mudallisu, وَيَرِدُ بِسِيغَةِ تَحْتَبِلُ الْلُقِيَّ كَعَنْ وَقَالَ. He would use words that he heard this from this person. وَكَذَا الْمُرْسَلُ مِنْ مُعَاصِرٍ لَمْ يَلْقَى. The difference is مُعَاصَرَة. Pay attention. The mudallis, the one who just done the tadlis, he met me, but not this narration, he never took it from me. But he met me, we and him have spent time together. He just wasn't there that day when I was narrating the hadith. He's called the mudallis. And then what he does is that, he attributes that narration to me directly. When he wasn't there that day, he never heard it from me. Mursal, on the other hand, he's the same as the tadlis, which is that they're both attributing to me something which they never heard from me. The only difference is that the Mudallis met me and the Mursal Khafi never ever met me. But he resided at the same time as me. We lived at the same era, we lived at the same time. He could have met me. But Taba'ud al-Aqtar, the land was distance or whatever may be the reason. Are you with me? Does that make more sense now? Has nothing to do with Sahabi or Tabi'i.
Not
He never narrated anything from me, never met me.
The Mursal al-Khafi, because as you said, Mu'asara, and you said that he never met you.
Mm-hmm.
You said that he could have gone.
He could have met me if he wanted to. He has the ability.
I saw another definition. He said that he could have met him, but it's not proven that he narrated from him.
Could have met him. Yeah, 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 it's true. There's nothing showing that he narrated from me. Sah, exactly what I'm saying. You have to mind my English. This is how the way I do things. Sah, I'm reading it from Arabic. All of it I'm reading is from Arabic. I'm translating on the spot. I'm making up some English words as I go along. If it sounds right, I say. If it doesn't, Hey, fadl.
قال رحمه الله تعالى ثم الطعن إما أن يكون لكذب الراوي أو تهمته بذلك أو فحش غلطه أو غفلته أو فسقه أو وهمه أو مخالفته أو جهالته أو بدعته أو سوء حفظه فالأول الموضوع والثاني المتروك والثالث المنكر على الرأي وكذا الرابع والخامس ثم الوهم إن اطلع عليه بالقرائن وجمع الطرق فالمعلل ثم المخالفة إن كان بتغيير السياق فمدرج الإسناد أو بدمج موقوف بمرفوع فمدرج المتن أو بتقديم أو تأخير فالمقلوب أو بزيادة راو فالمزيد في المتصل الأسانيد أو بإبداله ولا مرجح فالمضطرب وقد يقع الإبدال عمدا امتحانا أو بتغيير حروف مع بقاء السياق فالمصحف والمحرف ولا يجوز تعمد تغيير المتن بالنقص والمرادف إلا لعالم بما يحيل المعاني فإن خفي المعنى احتيج إلى شرح الغريب وبيان المشكل ثم الجهالة وسببها أن الراوي قد تكثر نعوته فيذكر بغير ما اشتهر به لغرض وصنفوا فيه الموضح وقد يكون مقلا فلا يكثر الأخذ عنه وفيه الوحدان أو لا يسمى اختصارا وفيه المبهمات ولا يقبل المبهم ولو أبهم بلفظ التعديل على الأصح فإن سمي وانفرد واحد عنه فمجهول العين أو اثنان فصاعدا ولم يوثق فمجهول الحال وهو المستور ثم البدعة إما بمكفر أو بمفسق فالأول لا يقبل صاحبها الجمهور والثاني يقبل من لم يكن داعية في الأصح إلا إن روى ما يقوي بدعته فيرد على المختار وبه صرح الجوز جاني شيخ النسائي ثم سوء الحفظ إن كان لازما فالشاذ على رأي أو طارئا فالمختلط ومتى تبع سيء الحفظ بمعتبر وكذا المستور والمرسل والمدلس صار حديثهم حسنا لا لذاته بل بالمجموع.
Now the author رحمه الله he goes into the second type of rejected narrations. How many types did we say the rejected narrations were? Two. What was the first one? The chain of narration is disconnected. Now we're going to go into the second, which is الطعن في الراوي, criticism towards the narrator. The author mentioned it before, remember? Which is that the narrator is criticized. We're going to criticize the narrator. And the criticism of the narrator is two types. The first one is criticism in his adala. And the second one is criticism in his dabt, his precision and memory. Each one has five that comes under it. Altogether, it makes 10. Each one, there are five that come under it. So there are five under adala, and there are five under dabt. Are you with me, brothers? The author mentions all 10, he doesn't break it down like this, Ibn Hajar. He mentions it, but he doesn't put it under which of the five it is. But we're going to break them down. So the five are, I'm going to mention them, define them. The order is not good in his book. We've ordered it around correctly. So each one you can put under which party he means. So let's go to the first of the two that a narrator is criticized for. What is it? He said adala, his integrity, right? What's the first thing I said? Five, right? Right, number one. Al-kadhibu, he's a liar. Kadhab. Kadhib is lying. That narration is called what? Mawdu'. Take the ruling with it straight away. So he's got kadhib in him. The hukum of that hadith is what? Mawdu'. We're going to come to that. When he does tasrih al-sima' that he clearly states that he heard it, we're going to come to that. All the turuq al-tahammul, how to take it. I'm giving it bite size as we come. We go back to what we left before. Mention it again. It's right at the end, inshaAllah ta'ala. But you're good, mashaAllah, that you're alert and you've realized. The first one is al-kadhibu, lying. The hadith automatically is called what? Mawdu', fabricated. It's fabricated narration. What do? والكذب المختلق المصنوع على النبي فذلك الموضوع. Rejected. Fabricated narration. Made up. This person is a liar. أو تهمة بالكذب, which is the second. This is all his integrity. The second one is التهمة بالكذب. تهمة. تهمة means suspicion. How, why would they suspect somebody? How could you suspect a Muslim? So the scholars, they say the way to understand the dhabit for tuhmatul kadhib is that tuhmatul bil kadhib is two things. It's when two things are found. أن يظهر كذبه في حديث الناس. أن يظهر كذبه في حديث الناس. When he talks to the people, he's lying all day. But he doesn't lie about the Prophet yet. No one's got that on him. When he talks to the people, he lies. The second one is أَلَّا يُرْوَى ذَلِكَ الْحَدِيثِ أَلَّا يُرْوَى ذَلِكَ الْحَدِيثِ, that this narration is not narrated الَّذِي حَدَّثَ بِهِ, in which he has narrated إِلَّا مِنْ جِهَتِهِ, except from him. That's not enough lacking. وَيَكُونُ مُخَالِفًا وَيَكُونُ مُخَالِفًا قَوَاعِدَ الشَّرْعَ. It goes against the principles of the Sharia. No one's ever narrated this hadith except him. And then it goes against what? The qawa'id of the Sharia. This man is suspected to be a liar. He's tuhmat bil kadhib. His hadith is called what? What would we do to hadith? Matruk. Ibn Hajar tells you it. The one who is mutaham bil kadhib, matruk. His narration is. What's the third one? The third one is fuhsh. Sorry, fisq. The third one is fisq, he's a fasiq. The third one is, the tartib, we have to change it, I said. The reason is because he goes into dabt. We haven't finished adala yet. So the third one is fisq, he's a fasiq. His hadith is called, his hadith becomes munkar. Fasiq is a person who comes with major sins. Everyone does minor sins. That's nothing. I mean, when I say it's nothing, I don't mean do minor sins. I hope you don't take it like that. What I mean is that we're not looking for, no one's infallible to us, other than the Prophet ﷺ. Are you with me, brothers? So what we're demanding from that person is that they don't come with, what's the evidence that fisq means major sins? Didn't Allah say in the ayah, وَكَرَّحَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِسْيَانِ. Kufr, we understood it. Fusuq is what? وَالْعِسْيَان is what? Minor sins. So fisq here means major sins. He's a person who commits zina or whatnot. This individual's hadith becomes munkar. His hadith becomes munkar. Then we've got fourth, which is bid'ah. Bid'ah is adala. Are you with me, brothers? The fourth one is what? Bid'ah. He's an innovator. He's a what? He's an innovator. Ibn Hajar, if you look at his kitab, he mentions that the bid'ah, the mubtadi', he says that his narration is accepted with conditions. Sah? It's accepted with conditions. Illa, he says it here. يقبل من لم يكن داعية في الأصح إلا أن روى ما يقوي بدعته فيرد على المختار وبه صرح الجوزجاني شيخ النسائي. Is the innovative narration is accepted when two conditions are present. The first one is, by the way, the bid'ah has to be bid'ah مفسقة, not bid'ah مكفرة. It can't be a bid'ah which is kufr. It has to be bid'ah mufassaqa, bid'ah fisq. Now the fisq is not the one we just mentioned, major sin, because kabira is bid'ah is actually bigger than the kabira. Are you with me, brothers? The first one is, the first condition is alla yakuna da'iyan ila bid'ati. This person should not be a person who calls to his innovation. He's a mubtadi', but he hides it. He doesn't tell people about it. So the scholars divide between a mubtadi' who calls to his innovation and a mubtadi' who hides his bid'ah. He does it behind closed doors. He celebrates the Prophet's birthday in his house. He doesn't tell anybody to do it. He doesn't go out and do it in public. He just got his little thing going on in his house. Yeah? That's غير داعٍ إلى بدعتي. He's not a caller to his bid'ah. And no one it's not anyone's job to investigate on him. Second one is, the second condition, so he can't be a caller to his bid'ah. The second one is أَلَّا يَكُونَ فِي مَا رَوَاهُ مَا يُقَوِّي تِلْكَ الْبِدْعَةِ. This narration which he is narrating should also not be a narration that supports his belief. So if he's got tashayyu', it can't be a narration that talks about فَضَائِلُ عَلِي, the virtues of Ali. Or if it's a khariji, مثلاً, it can't be any narrations pertaining to what? Against Ali. Are you with me? Or anything to do with kaba'ir, major sins. Are you with me, brothers? This is something that strengthens his belief. So he's gonna, even if he may be or not be a liar, but he may, scholars don't take it. The fifth and the last one for the criticism of the narrator in terms of his integrity, adala, is al-jahala. He's unknown. Are you with me, brothers? He's what? He's majhool. And Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he mentioned three causes that bring about jahala of a narrator. Ibn Hajar here mentions three things that bring about jahala regarding a narrator. The first one is kathratu nu'ut al-rawi. There's so many different descriptions this narrator is being given. Different attributes are being given to him. Okay? And the person who's doing that is doing it mibabi tadlis. Remember? Sheikh told us, Sheikh Faisal last time. Are you with me? My name is Abdurrahman Hassan. People know me as Abdurrahman Hassan. But you go to the people and you say it's Abdurrahman Roble. And that's my ancestor's name. So you say it's Abdurrahman Robo. I have to make it to English, Robo. Roble sounds very fresh. Huh? Probably it's not in English. Somebody once said to me, that's a white guy's name, or it's an English name. No, it's not. It's just, I think my granddad was born on a rainy day, so they just named him after that. Problem is, it's a rainy day. Yeah? So somebody calls me by that name. Or they say, Abu Salma, which is my oldest daughter's name. All of that, you're changing my disc. All of them are who I am. But you're doing that tadlis and to fool the people. So it looks like you've got so many different shuyukhs that you took knowledge from. Tadlis. Are you with me? That makes it hard for people to know who this narrator is. It becomes hard. Are you with me? وَلِذَلِكَ Muhammad ibn Yahya al-Duhali did that when he came to Imam al-Bukhari after the issue of the conflict of the Qur'an being makhluq. Remember, lafzi bil Qur'ani makhluq. Muhammad ibn Yahya al-Duhali was an imam in A'immat al-Sunnah, but something happened between him and Imam al-Bukhari, a little conflict. So he narrated a hadith from him, and when he did, he didn't want people to know. Now he still narrates from him, or he took that particular hadith from him, and he doesn't want to attribute it to him. So he changed his name. He said Muhammad ibn Ismail or Muhammad ibn Ibrahim, something like that. He changed the name from Bukhari, which is very well known for. Some scholars became hard for them to know who this person was. Are you with me? He was doing it because he just didn't want to narrate. He needed the narration. Bukhari is reliable. He needs the narration, but he doesn't want to mention his name. So that's one way Hafiz Muhajjar mentions. The second is, this person has little narrations. And this is what the scholars talk about in the chapters of known as Al-Wuhdan. Muslim wrote a book on this. Al-Wuhdan. Al-Wuhdan, books of, if you see a book called Wuhdan, it means this person's got one or few teachers. Are you with me? He's got very little narrators, or he took knowledge from very little. There's this rare in his narrations. It's called Wuhdan. That's the second reason why somebody may not be known. The last but not least is, the scholar's name, تَرْكُ تَسْمِيَةَ الرَّاوِي اخْتِصَارًا. The name of the narrator is summarized from what his lengthy name was, summarized. So it becomes very hard. This is the books of Al-Mubhamat, they talk about that. So the first one, when the person had too many descriptions, if you want to learn more about that, you can look into the chapters of Al-Muwaddih. And the second one is Al-Wuhdan, and the third one is Al-Mubhamat. Are you with me, brothers? Then Hafiz ibn Hajar mentions that the majhul is two types. The majhul is what? Two types. The first one is majhul, which is mubham. A person who's unknown, he's unknown, and he's ambiguous in terms of praise or criticism. Are you there, brothers? So he's ambiguous and he's unknown. So it's two types. For example, a person is mubham from any types of ta'deel. So for example, somebody says, Ar-rajulin thiqqatin. Thiqqatin is what? It's a hukum. He's got a ruling placed on him, but he's still not known who is he. So somebody says, Akhbarani thiqqa, a reliable person told me. Okay, we know he's reliable, but who is he? Are you there? That's a jahala, but that jahala is called mubhamun ala ta'deel. The second one is called mubhamun dun ta'deel. This person is ambiguous and there's no praise. A man told me, Ar-rajulin is unknown. None of those two do we accept. Tell us. Your ruling, we might differ with it when you tell us who it is. Sah? Tell us who it is. None of those two are accepted. The second one is al-majhul al-mu'ayyan. A specific person is unknown. Specific person. And two fall under that. Hafiz ibn Hajar mentions it. One is known as majhul al-ayn and majhul al-hal. Majhul al-ayn and majhul al-hal. Are you with me? Majhul al-ayn means what? Majhul al-ayn means this person, he himself is not known. Majhul al-hal means he's known, but his situation is not known. It's also known where you sama masturan, as Hafiz ibn Hajar mentioned. It's also called what? It's also called mastur. We've now finished ta'anul rawi. We'll take another, inshallah ta'ala, 5, 10, 15 minutes break again. And we'll come back again, inshallah ta'ala.